Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my death to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Welcome to Single and Married with Bimbo Odukwe.
When God made the woman, he called her a helpmate. And so the first thing I must understand about the woman is, she's created to what? To help me, to complete me, not compete with me. I must see her as a vessel of honor. And that's why the Bible says, I should treat her with honor. Praise the Lord. She was created for me, to do something for me. And so when the woman gets married, she herself cannot be selfish. She must understand the fact that she was created for the man. And her basic work is to what? Try to help that man incubate and develop the dreams and visions that God has given to him. And as his support, she must try to support him. And she must make sure that all that she does is in unity with what he wants to do. And he also must understand that and make sure that all that he does is in unity with her, so both of them can agree. Now, the Bible calls her a helpmate. As a helpmate, she's called to help, to aid, to surround, to protect, and defend that man. Right in every woman, she has that ability and she has that motivation to always want to do something for the man. And it's basically, she wants to help the man, she wants to complete the man, she wants to surround the man, because God made her to be a helpmate. Now, that is why a woman has to be very careful. You see, because the woman has the tendency to want to give and do something for the man to make sure she completes the man and to make sure she's valued by the man. Remember, God made her for the man. It is easy in courtship for the woman to give herself to the man sexually. Not because she really needs sex. No. It's because inside her, she wants to give. She wants to surround. She wants to contribute. She wants to let the man know that she's valuable to him. She wants to complete him. Do you understand? That's why God made her. And so there's a tendency for her to always want to give herself to any man that she feels is interested in her. At the end of the day, some women don't enjoy sex, premarital sex. But there's that thing in them that wants to just give. I want the man to value me. I want the man to esteem me. I want the man to know I'm valuable to him. He can't do without me. Which is why God made a woman. But it is that sin nature in us that we want to do that outside marriage. Now, let me now say something about premarital sex that is very important. In Genesis 2, the Bible says, therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall what? Cleave unto his wife, and it shall be one flesh. Now, why do you think God said that to the man? Because God is trying to tell the man, when you get married, the only helper that you need, or the one helper you need and that will never leave you, is the woman. And therefore, do everything to cleave to her alone. Always be in agreement with your husband or your wife. If the husband or the wife becomes one or starts to work in agreement with somebody else outside his union, the husband or the wife will work in against that covenant relationship that is so powerful that is made to do something. If the husband starts to agree with other women outside his marriage, his mother, his auntie, his sister, his cousin, his younger sister, or other women around him, he can never enjoy the power of the oneness. Likewise, if a woman starts to work against her husband's will, because the husband and the wife are supposed to always agree and always do something together, and then they are very powerful. But if a woman starts to agree with her mother or her father or her friends, and she starts to work against that man, because there is no way they can become one when they are working against each other, so working for one another. The reason why you are supposed to become one. Now, you must understand, oneness is not for sex. Oneness is to be what? United to do something. But let me explain something about sex. Why premarital sex is very dangerous. Number one, God said the man should leave the father and mother and cleave and become one flesh with a person called wife. God did not say the man should become one flesh with so many women. Nor did he say that the woman should become one flesh with so many men. But what do we have working against our marriages? Before marriage, the woman has become one flesh with so many men. And so she has become in agreement spiritually, even in her thinking. Are you with me? That's not the way we used to do it. That's the way we used to do it. That's not the way a man should do it. Why? Because she has had sex with another man. When a woman becomes one flesh with so many men, and when a man becomes one flesh with so many men, they are working against the purpose of marriage in the first place. What God wants to achieve is already messed up. Something is gone wrong somewhere. Because when God, the way God made it and the way the system is supposed to work, is the man is supposed to be one flesh with just one woman. He didn't make three Eves for Adam. He made just one Eve. He said the man should leave his wife and leave the father and mother and cleave to his own wife, not wives. And he should become one. That means the man is made psychologically, mentally, physically to only become one with one person. Now, when the man becomes one with one woman before marriage, what happens is this. Something is transferred to that man, just like something is transferred to that woman. Now, what I'm going to show you today is this. When a man has sex with a woman, and that man has had sex with so many women, if that woman he had sex with was a virgin, what's going to happen is this. He's going to transfer to that woman a spirit of immorality, a spirit of lust, a spirit of fornication, which is what is operating. And if he has slept with many women, he will have picked so many spirits from those women. He might have picked pornography from one, he could have picked masturbation from one, he could have picked lying spirit from one, and then of course, immorality and fornication is already there. And so by the time he sleeps with that woman, he has passed all that to her. Now, what will not happen is this. Because it's a covenant thing, and because every time you become one, there's the ability to reproduce and replenish. That woman will not realize that something has happened in her. If she was lustful before in number one degree, by the time she sleeps with that man, there's a tendency for her to now become very lustful. She will now realize that things will now start to happen. There's going to be a thirst for sex. She might get herself into masturbation. She might get herself into pornography. She might imagine herself thinking lustfully. Not because she was like that before, but something was transferred to her. Are you with me? Now, the woman now sleeps with another man. She will go ahead and transfer all she has got. And the man will also transfer all he has got to her. So you can imagine what is happening. You see, every time you have premarital sex, you are messing up your life. That's the point you must understand. And the thing is this. If that spirit, now listen closely to me. If that spirit is not handled before marriage, what will happen is this. By the time you both marry, now, if a man who has been sexually active and who has not broken that spirit, because when you are born again, you can break that spirit. And I'm going to take you to a prayer so we can be sure that we all break that spirit. All those that have been sexually active, even if you are born again. Now, the thing is this. If a man, that's if you haven't done that before, if a man who has been sexually active becomes born again and he does not stand and break all the spirits he has picked up from so many women, if he marries a virgin, what is going to happen is this. He's going to automatically transfer so many things to her. That woman that used to be very moral can start doing things that is very unlike her. It might be that woman that will be losing the relationship. Because something has been passed to her. But the worst part of this is this. If that spirit is not broken, automatically it's passed to the children. Automatically. And that is why you will find out that what happened in the life of your parents automatically starts to happen in your life. Because something was passed down from your parents to you. And as long as that spirit is not arrested, it's operating, and so it goes from generation to generation. And so you say, oh, this is what happens in their family. You see, one of the reasons why God says you should not get into premarital sex is this. When you have been sexually active and you have not broken that spirit, apart from just breaking the spirit, you have not broken some covenant words as you spoke, I cannot do without you. You are the only one for me. I will marry you. And all those things they've said to you, they're all words. All covenant words. You are mine forever. I cannot, anywhere you go in this world, even if I don't marry you, I'm my own. Now, words, vows, oaths, all those words, vows, and oaths should be rejected. Plus the words you remember, plus one you don't remember. Just every word, every oath I've got into, or somebody have said to me that is not of the Lord, that has been said to me outside my husband or wife, I break, I nullify the effect in my life. Because all these things have a way of penetrating into your home. Now, a man can be married and still have a mental view of most of the women he slept with. And while he's sleeping with his wife, he's remembering having pictures in his mind of the women he has slept with. And sometimes where they have problems in their marriage sexually, it's because he starts to compare one woman to the one he's married to. And he starts to feel, oh, she's not doing it very well. That woman used to do this. And that way, even mentally, he's messed up. And so there's a problem already in the system. Because God had a purpose for creating the woman. God had a purpose for creating the man. And there was something he was supposed to do. And he said, you are to cleave to only one person. But the point is this. Okay, I'm a Christian. And I break it. Because you see, that's the advantage of being born again. Christ comes in. And the blood of Christ, and you can break and pull down and destroy, and you are free. And so you now have a second virginity. But imagine you going back again into sex before marriage. The Bible says when you cast out a demon and it goes, you fill yourself with the word. It says once the demon sees that, the whole place is clean. When he's going to come back this time, more will... Seven more will come. Greater ones will come. Because they want to be sure that this time, by the time you want them to go, they have their hold. But there you are. You stand on the word, because the word of God will do anything. You stand on the word of God. You stand on the blood of Jesus. And you cover yourself again. And then you get into it again. Can you see what you're doing to yourself? Can you see how you are messing up your life? Because remember, the power of every marriage is in what? Agreements. And if I'm agreeing with somebody else, I'm in agreement with somebody else mentally or physically or spiritually, I'm already against myself in my marriage. Are you with me? And when God says, wife, honor your husband, or husband, love your wife, he has a purpose. The purpose is for him to be able to bless you. And when you go outside the will of God and you start to do things your own way, you start to run here, you start to run there. But this, another problem you're going to have is this. You see, a lot of people feel, well, I might be a single parent, doesn't matter. I will just have a child. You know, I'll have a child for that one. Have a child for that one. Have a child for that one. But by the time you have a child for that one, apart from the fact that you have a problem emotionally, because you see, God made you to have feelings for just one person, and that person to have feelings for you. And both of you to complement and complete yourselves. But there you are. The man that you have a child for is not yours. It belongs to another woman. yet you have a child for another man. Or maybe you don't have the child, you have slept with another man. So emotionally, you are messed up. You are messed up emotionally. There's no happiness, there's no joy, there's no peace. And the children that you've had, there are different traits in them already. They have picked different things on the different men you slept with. And if that spirit or whatever it is that is operating in that man is not broken over their lives, they will automatically reflect that man. They will not only look like him physically. They will look like him spiritually. They will look like him mentally. All the spirits operating, they will do everything he did. Praise the Lord.
In 1992, my life changed. Based on what Pastor Bimbo has been talking about. Okay, I come from a family where my mother gave me everything. My father died when I was about 10. So my mom had been in charge. But before my father died, I only saw my parents have an argument once. There was always peace. So I was from a standard home, no problems. But my problem was from outside. I went out with this guy who was depressed. All my life, I only heard of the word depression. I just did not know the meaning of depression until I met this guy. He was a definition of depression. I'm sorry, hold on please. I am not saying this because I want you to laugh, because it is not funny. You know, he came from a broken home. His mother married another wife, you know, his father married other wives, you know, that. And that really affected him. That was what got him into that depression for years. Every single person he came in contact with, he had problems with. But I didn't know. I was very young, you know. When your parents tell you something, please listen. I did not sit down. I was a teenager. I had just entered my early teens, for Pete's sake. And I went out with this guy. And you know what Pastor Bimba's talked about? When you sleep with a guy, everything is transferred to you. What year are we in? We're in the year 2002. For 9 years. Pastor Bimba, I told you about this last year. Last year was when I started coming out of depression. So for all those who have known me before 92, you have not seen the real me. Because the real me was covered for years in one person that I met and an act that I got myself into. Because I found out that when Pastor Bimbo is talking sometimes, we say, she's a pastor. But I'm not a pastor. I'm not a head of a department. I'm just like one of you. And I'm telling you, that you get involved in something and it hooks your life. It's like taking drugs, man. I didn't take drugs. Just one guy. And my life was almost messed up. Because I didn't understand. I was just a very free person. If I tell you yes, yes is yes. If I tell you no, no is no. I didn't understand what deceit was until I met this guy. He lied from the beginning to the end. I'm sorry. Look, you know what? I was pained for years. But last year, I forgave him because I understood that he did not know any better. Because really, you cannot give what you don't have. Thank you.
That's a good testimony.
I remember the day I got disvirgined. There's this thing people normally say. They said that when you get disvirgined, nothing changes. You're just the same, you know. There's no difference. They can't tell anything outwardly and all that and everything. But I remember the day I got disvirgined, and in the room with this guy, and I asked him, I said, do I look any different? He was like, no. And I'm like, am I walking any different? He's like, no, you're okay, you're normal. You know, and one thing I've realized with time is that you might not look any different physically, but the moment you do that, the moment you sleep with that man, emotionally, spiritually, everything-wise, you change. And you don't change for the better, you change for the worse. You see, and honestly, when I sat down there and Pastor Mimbo was talking, and I just realized that before I got disvirgined, I was somebody else. I was free, I was loving, I was confident. And from the day I got disvirgined till the day I rededicated my life, I have slept with all sorts of sizes, shapes. And I'm not coming here to brag or anything. I need us to be very practical. You see, I'm a living testimony that the word of God works. And it doesn't happen overnight. I didn't only sleep with men, I slept with women. So you should know how deep I was into the thing. You see, and I'm coming here to say, because I know there are people here, you know, Pastor Mimba has talked about sleeping with only guys and sleeping with women as per men. But there are women here and there are men here that you know you sleep with women and you know you are sleeping with guys. It's the same thing. You have to get out of this thing. A woman will still pass the same spirit to you. The man will still pass the same spirit to you. Because I just had a very strong feeling in my spirit that when Pastor Bimbo was talking, some people were here justifying themselves. At least I'm born again now. Should be I just sleep with women? At least you don't get pregnant. You can't catch AIDS. You can't catch this. I'm telling you, the moment you sleep with a woman or you sleep with a man, this kind of spirits, I sleep at night, women are chasing me. It's horrible. I'm telling you, but I thank God that I've gotten my deliverance. Pastor Bimbo has been working with me. Pastor Taiwo has been working with me. And I'm standing here to tell you that it's a living nightmare. Please, if anybody is here, you've not gotten into it yet, please, I beg you. Or if you've gotten into it, please get out of it. It's a living nightmare. And I'm standing here to tell you that, man, I'm free. And at last, I'm enjoying my freedom. To the glory of God. Amen.
Now, praise. I was told from the history I had from my father, my grandfather has 8 wives. And each wife has a child outside before marrying him. My father has 4 wives. All those 4 wives, every one of them has children outside marriage. My elder brother. He has a wife now, and is planning to go for another one. Coming to me now. Before I came to Fountain of Life, I normally tell people, I'm not handsome, but I thank God for one thing, I'm very intelligent. And because of that, I know women, they like about 4 things in men. If you are not handsome, intelligent, you have money, or you have good outfits, I possess at least one. And because of that intelligence, before I gave my life to Christ, at least in a month, I normally count them in my fingers. I sleep with 4 girls. And I began to look at it from what she said. You see, if a man sleeps with different kind of women, if he gives birth to a child, that child is going to carry that trait. It's a spiritual thing. Before I gave my life to Christ, I tell a lot of lies. My father tells me, don't let me just say it. I'm being practical, and I'm saying this for you to learn from it. It's very, very important you learn from this thing.
So how are you doing? I'm sure you enjoy the program that you just finished watching. I want you to know that Single and Married brings you a message of love, and basically it's a message that says that you're special, God loves you, you're going to make it, regardless of what you're going through, God is on your side. Single or married, the Lord has great plans for you this year. This is your year of glorious abundance. Be expectant this year. The Lord is going to bless you tremendously. But what you need to do to make sure that this year is that year of harvest and the year of restoration for you is simply to give your heart to Jesus. When Jesus comes in, then you can smile all the day. And remember, no matter what you're going through, it's a stepping stone to victory. If you want to give your heart to Christ, just say this prayer with me. Say, Heavenly Father, I ask you come into my heart today, Lord Jesus Christ. I want to accept you as my Lord and Savior. Change my heart, change my life. Come in and save me. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. If you said that prayer, you're now a new creature. Come to church, we'll be glad to see you. And remember, this year is your year of great happenings. The Lord is going to surprise you. Jesus loves you, and I love you too. God bless you.
I am sure you've enjoyed this episode of Single and Married. Join us again next week.
Single and Married is a ministry of the Fountain of Life Church in Lopeju, Lagos, anchored by Pastor Bimbo Odukoya, the Associate Senior Pastor. Pastor Taiwo Odukoya, the Senior Pastor of the Fountain of Life Church, invites you to worship with us on Sundays. First service, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Second service, 9:15 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Mondays, 6 p.m. at the Singers Fellowship. Wednesdays, 6 p.m. at the Matrix Service. Thursdays, 6 p.m. at the Married Men and Married Women's Fellowships. All audio and videotapes of Single and Married plus other audio and videotapes addressing various marital and single issues are available for sale at the Fountain of Life Church, 12 Industrial Estate Road by PZ Industries, off Town Planning Way in Lopeju, Lagos. Telephone number 496-8646 or 496-8647. Thank you and God bless.
To the cross.